And welcome back again to Throne of Darkness. In the last part, I showed you how to grind, where to grind copper shells and gold. Let me show the results. Let's get our team together. And we got hold of a lot of some tango feathers. The rest must be kept by the ninja. A lot of tango feathers, of Yoyami blood, a lot of copper blood, and a whole lot of copper shells. And we got our first two multiplicators. It's a silver ingot and sulfur, and the ultimate gold Kenja stone and some crab stones. Let me explain multiplicators. You already have seen this crafting here with three demo blubbers. The demo blubbers are earth components, and this here is a effect earth components. This is a multiplicator. Let me take my other sword and fill in only two demos and use. I only got hold of one silver ingot, and if I place this here, this will affect, you see, he charges me with 700 gold, and now with 3800 gold, I can barely pay it. I have grinded a lot of gold in the copper layer, but I need this, and therefore I show with one of these. But first explanation, this is a multiplicator. This will give me 5 leech plus 5 leech are 10 leech, and this here and this thing here will double it, means 20 leech. And this is a special ingredient. This is a specific multiplicator. This is a multiplicator for earth components. But instead sulfur as a multiplicator, also the single multiplicator. This only affects earth, and this only affects fire. Sulfur is a single fire multiplicator. The water multiplicator is quartz. I didn't found any of it. And the lightning multiplicator, single multiplicator, is quicksilver drops, and I didn't find them either. And there are the big multiplicators. There are the crappy ones who multiplicate like 4. Here, steel is for earth, fire, and water. This is cinnabar. It affects fire and water. And this is sapphire. It affects lightning and water. They are okay. You can use them, but they are not really good. The really good one is gold, because gold affects all 4, and I already find 2 of them. But take in consideration that are another downside of the big ones. The big ones take 4 places. Like, is this affecting Earth? Ah, this is affecting Earth. This takes 2 steps. That means that I can double. If I have 2 silver ingots, I could triple, because the silver ingot is a little bit smaller. The water quartz is also 2 places, and the quicksilver drops for lightning is 2 places too. Strangely, the fire multiplicator sulfur is 4 places, like gold, and you can use gold instead of this. Let's make this and show you its effect. Yes, I can use the money. And let me show you another grind spot to grind. Where is it? It's Mogami River. To grind for copper shells and copper blood, I took this part. You may already know female ninjas, crab droppers. Oh, a mask. And light health. Here. I already have shown you here in the behind the waterfall lies the copper layer, but we took another approach to another part where I tried to grind here a lot of these ladies, and these ladies can drop a hairpin, and I desperately need either a hairpin Oh, it's a destroyed temple. This is a place where the this is a place important for the story, but we are in multiplayer, therefore we don't get the quest here. These ladies drop hairpins, but very, very rare. You have to kill approximately 100 of them to get the hairpin, and these ladies are often present in so-called ambushes. Ambushes are places stacked with furniture where archers are hiding. These are the stalks again. And I think if I remember correctly, it can be that I'm wrong, but dogs or wolves, I don't want to shame them. Yeah, some around here. Can it be that I am wrong? Here should be an ambush. And in these ambushes, very often these priest ladies are present. And these are places where... Oh, these are Onis. These are the next monster I try to grind because I want their teeth. I need their teeth. Tengus again. But I already got enough of their feathers. And close. Let's take... Where is the ambush? Can it be that I'm wrong? Oh! Here starting the territory of the Odda clan. Here you can see their mono. Oh, and the sword is ready. Here is the normal sword with 15% leech. And here's the improved sword with multiplication with 20% leech. It would be even more. It would be 30% if I had two ingots. And I found a jade. Jade is important for reflection builds because it got damage reflection. And here are some other items I found, but I will show you later. Where is the ambush I'm looking for? I think I got it wrong, and the ambush is somewhere else. Where am I? I think I got wrong. Let me save and exit. Open another multiplayer game. And first get the skilling right. I always save the skilling for the video. We got charisma. We need, let me look it up. We need strength. We have enough. We need 200 dexterity, which we can reach barely. Yes, we reached this. We reached the requirements for the best mod in game. Let what we do here. 22 Ki, let's improve his vitality a little bit. And he needs a lot of strange. Told better items. And he... Vitality needs too a lot of strength to get hold of better armor, and therefore coughing cutout, and therefore be able to get our boost items we are creating in an instant. He needs strength too, but not so much. Let's keep it. Yes, and dexterity. And oh, spell tree. Spell tree for us, we got nothing of interest yet. The passive skills have already been maxed. This is two, nothing of interest. This two is not. Oh, we can max this ability. Very nice ability. And let's save the rest for this thing up there. Dexterity increase. Mm-hmm. These are the shock blades, the blade mechanics. This is flash strike. Flash strike is the same as furious attack, but this is for ranged items and this is for other items, but we prefer the KI barrier. Let me level this. KI barrier is already maxed, unfortunately. Let me max the blade. the blade. And we are out of points. What can he learn? Oh, he can increase his dexterity passively. Very important. And shock blade. Nothing of interest here. Nothing of interest here. He needs to keep leveling a little bit to reach this. And let's maximize his sword abilities. I think he should use water. So let me start now by explaining how to create push items. Push items are usually created this way. There are two components which can boost our strength and our dexterity. The copper blood will boost our strength and the tango feathers will boost our dexterity. Therefore, I often go this way. I take arm armor and put as many copper blood in them as I can get. Oh, and a red soul sharp. It would be a waste to waste this place. Therefore, I try to get strength boosting arms. Yes, I know, this is very Zelda-like. And try to get dexterity boosting foot armor. Let's look at this. It's got now plus 10 strength, plus 10 vitality. This is copper blood. Copper blood does a potion, does plus 5 strength and plus 5 vitality a potion. And the plus 5 key is from the sharp. Now get me my boots and stuff them up with tango feathers. I could remove two feathers and insert a stone instead, but it would be the same. Two feathers divided by two would be four feather effects, and four feather effects have effects of four feathers. From this perspective, it's the same. I too got a new helmet and a little bit new stuff. And I got, if you play multiplayer, you can kill Buaku in the Citadel basement multiple times to get his sword multiple times. A very good boost for the start, but its swords are not the best in the game. There are betters like the Iaito. This blacksmith is finished. And we got plus 20 dexterity. And therefore I create items and especially for the purpose. I create armor items especially for the purpose to get hold on better swords, which is very intelligent in my opinion. Let me look. Yes, we are able to use Iaito with this 150 maximum damage. And therefore let me show you the right grinding spot for priest's hairpins. The first thing you should do to get hold of hairpins is go to Mori Village, because in multiplayer some monsters are randomized, and these randomized monsters can be priestess. Run up there, run to the field. The randomized monsters are tengus. Tengus are a lot. It would be better for me if they would be onis, but later more. Oh, a single scale. I
have the strength to carry it.
I can scavenge.
Too much. Cannot carry that.
I am very overburdened. And more of the fields are, yeah, they are wolves. Unfortunately for us. Because the game sets these both enemy types randomly. There are often tengus, female ninjas, ghost armors, fallen foot soldiers, or very rare wood onis. And up here can be wolves, evil priests, priestess, and I think this, there were the three, they could be there. So start your run here, and if you don't get hold of priestesses, very complicated plural, you can go on here. Oh, let me explain a bit about the map, about the strings. The golden string is where you're supposed to be, and the blue string are the strings that are lead to the mountain in the center of the world map, where the Dark Warlord's castle lies. If you try to go down there in the companion, the your daimyo will tell you don't go there, it's too hard, and it's quite hard because there's a very strong magician down there, and the monsters there don't drop anything good. It's not very worse. More female ninjas. Bad dropping, expect of some masks. I got a lot of these. I should have given me some key points to use this. Next, and where is my ambush? Ah, there are some cutesy kappas. I killed a lot of them in their lair. The big ones are very cool because they take a lot of damage and drop a lot of gold. Oh, damage. Yes, this is very unfortunate. The ninja's new throwing weapon broke down in the time the blacksmith worked for me. Female ninjas was very little of interest for me. And another kappa. Ah, here's the one way. Oh, a little note on masks. Early masks tend to have nearly very low durability. This mask I got awesome 25 percentage, which is very nice, but only 2 durability, which means the mask broke down very frequently. I think I know where the ambush is. Oh, another sapphire stone, one of the crap ones. Here's a kappa boss, it's Umagoroshi. Let's kill him. And you can see, due to my 2 new swords with reach ability, I can almost not die as long as I hit something, which is very important in the game. Let me cross this bridge, more female ninjas. Health. Take it. And I think if I go straight right, there should be the cemetery, where I have no business this time. Okay, priest is ready with my weapon. Hold it, they are stuffed up. Throw away this, take this, auto sword. It's his bow is broken. Let me repair it. I don't care about his mask, I don't care about my mask, and we have some level ups, but let me check this later. First of all, we are going to... Oh, another kappa boss, Zuima, but no problem, due to advanced leech, I just can't die from these enemies. And the whole goal is that we have so much leech that we can't be killed by the Dark Warlord. Oh, these dragons again. Where? The ambush seems to be... Yes, these are... This type of enemy will poison you. Purple Soul Sharp. Usable. I forgot what this... I forgot what it does. Yes! Here's the ambush. There are a lot of skeleton archers behind cover. You have to crack down first. And in the middle, yes, there are a lot of priestesses. And this is the way to try to grind for an hairpin. It's very difficult because one of our own wrench fighters died and they are trying to dodge. Die, drop a hairpin, drop a hairpin. Just gold. Could you please so polite and drop a hairpin? I desperately need one. And I'm going to die because I'm not able to hit the archers properly to heal myself. Come on. Dodging range enemies are the only things you can still kill you if you got a decent amount of leech. Let me level my ninja. My ninja needs key and strength. And my bowman needs vitality and strength. And he needs key and strength. Nice. Where are... Here's my sword. Unfortunately, my new sword did not get leech from the start. But if I have enough demo blubber left for components, I could modify it for a very, very great amount of gold. I don't have that gold. And this will take us in the next episode, where I can tell you where I will tell you how you can stop grinding and get stuff for free. But this is cheating, and before this I will show you another neat trick. Oh, not a trick, in another area where you can grind for Oni Teeth, because Hairpin and Oni Teeth are literally the same. They are both water components. They took both two fields, two slots, and both give you 5% leech. And it does not really matter if you got hold of hairpins or Oni Teeth, but Oni Teeth are a little bit easier to get. But a little cut here till I am fully regenerated, and till then.